I'm not gonna mulligan this hand. It has a turn 3 Jace. And he's on the mulligan. It's a little bit flooded, this hand is, but yeah, that makes it much worse. One of the things that's so great about that deck is it just has that kind of nut draw of turn 1 Duress, turn 2 Signet, turn 3 Planeswalker, and it has 2 Signets, 2 Duress effects, and 2 Planeswalkers. So it actually gets those type of draws on a somewhat consistent basis, which is pretty impressive. So here, I think I'm going to go Cobra, Explore, Fetch, Go. Well, I might actually just go Cobra, Fetch, Go, and then hopefully be able to go big on the following turn. Because I have a second Cobra. Yeah, I'm going to do that. And that's awkward. One of my concerns about this line was him having the removal spell and then drawing the land. But I figured it was enough of a corner case that I wasn't going to worry about it. I'm starting to regret that decision. Oh boy. Alright. So, Cobra. I may want to wait to do any more. Yeah, I am going to wait. I could have tried to keep going off, but I think I'd rather wait till I have a mana sink like Raging Ravine that may actually need the extra mana. Because it would be really nice if I could Raging Ravine as Tezzeret next turn while keeping up mana leak. It's interesting, he's been missing a lot with Tezzeret. I don't really know the numbers on that deck, but I'd be curious how likely that is to happen. So we know he has a Tezzeret in hand here. The problem is, I'm not sure I can beat a Tumble Magnet. It's also really interesting that he tapped the Ink Moth Nexus for that. I'm not sure why. There's no double colored cards in the deck. Maybe he has a single colored card in hand like Disfigure, and also has... And we know his other card's Forge Master, so he has this figure, but he doesn't want to use the Sphere counter. That seems like the most likely case to me. It's also possible that he just knew he wasn't going to block with Nexus since he needs the 5 mana. I'm definitely going to let Tumble Magnet resolve, though. I have to save the mana leak for the Forge Master. One problem is I do have to find a way to make... to put some pressure on him here. I guess I'll lead with an Explore. Okay, so he did have go for the throat. I'm definitely not countering that. I don't really have a desire to ravine him right now, considering, first of all, that he has Tumble Magnet, and second of all, that I have to keep up leak. I knew there was something sketchy about not leaving up that Ink Moth Nexus. And that's a Battle Sphere. He's going to be a little... Oh, so now he can play the... I have to leak that Forge Master, even though he's going to Battlesphere me. I just don't have a choice. And I'm probably dead now. Planeswalkers plus Bumble Magnet are just so powerful. Alright, well, I can't. The bad news is I can't Raging Ravine him anymore. The good news is I'm not dead anymore. Definitely just gonna ship the turn here. The good news is that I might do this anyway just to bluff, because I'm so dead to the battle sphere. I'm going to mana leak that, because there's no real reason not to. And I actually want him to pay 3, since that'll mean that he won't be able to Ink Moth Nexus me this turn. Which is actually a pretty realistic strategy for him. It's very possible he could just win the game if he Ink Moth, if he animated Ink Moth Nexus and Tezzereted it. But he is paying. Alright, success. So you found the chalice that will allow him to play the... Now I can ravine him while keeping up leak, although he probably won't be too impressed. I have a feeling that if he draws a land, he's gonna go for it regardless. He did. Yep, that's fine. He can now probably just Tezzeret ultimate me out. If not this turn, then very shortly. I can't think of any real outs for me. And that'll about do it. Alright, game 3 time. Yeah, still looking at sideboard. Retropon isn't bad, but... I just really don't like the way it plays. I guess I kind of... I don't know. I guess on the play, it's a little better, since... it's more realistic for it to shut down something. You can probably get away with cutting two Titans, I don't know.